We will demonstrate how to properly strip and refinish a VCT floor utilizing Greening the Cleaning products. You will need the following equipment and materials: GTC Clear Cut Floor Stripper, GTC Zinc Free Floor Finish, 3 mop buckets with ringers, 3 mop handles, mops, dust mop, finish mop, scraper, drop cloths, tape, black stripping pad, wet vacuum, 175 RPM rotary floor machine, doodle pad holder and pad, large plastic trash can liner, wet floor signs, and lastly, gloves. Prepare the stripping solution bucket and rinse buckets. Our first bucket will be for the stripper. Pour 1 quart of GTC Clear Cut Floor Stripper into 4 gallons of cold tap water. Fill the other 2 mop buckets with cold tap water for rinsing. Next, we want to prepare the area that is being stripped and refinished. Place wet floor signs out to block off the work area. Tape down drop cloths in any area that you do not want stripper leaking into. For example, corridor doorways and cross corridors. Next, dust mop the area to remove any debris, hair, or dust. After this is complete, use a baseboard stripper or GTC Clear Cut Floor Stripper in your bucket and soak the baseboards. Let that sit for a few minutes, then with a doodle pad holder and pad, scrub the baseboard, corners, and edges. Once this is complete, flood the area that you are working in with your stripper solution. Let sit for at least 5 to 10 minutes. During this time, agitate the stripper solution on the floor with your mop. Once the stripper has set, begin stripping the floor with your rotary machine. Scrub left to right, then scrub back over the same area, right to left. Overlap at least 1/3 of the pad on the third pass. Next, blend the area in the first 2 passes by using overlapping counterclockwise loops. Repeat this process as needed. Once this is complete, pick up the stripper solution with a wet vacuum and mop down a heavy saturation of rinse water right away. You do not want stripper solution drying on your floor. Repeat rinsing 1 or 2 more times, then let it dry. Inspect the floor for any floor finish that still remains on the floor. Remove as needed. The floor is now ready to be finished. To save cleanup time and to keep your equipment clean, line your finish bucket with a plastic trash can liner. Place the approximate amount of finish necessary to do the job in the bucket. Immerse the mop in the finish and wring it out. Do not wring it out too much, but just enough so that there's no dripping. Next, begin laying your finish by cutting it along the edges. Stay at least 4 inches away from the baseboard on the first 2 coats, followed by filling in the area with a figure 8 pattern. On coats 3 and 4, finish to the edges and repeat the fill-in process. Let dry 20 to 30 minutes between coats, or when dry to the touch.